Mr. Resistor here, continuing our Alpha journey. And let's see, I guess I forgot to
warp drive active. Drive active. Drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted. Docking permission requested. Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
choice. So we'll try that.
Warp drive active. Drive active. Warp drive active.
Here. Well, here we go. Form a fleet. Two stacked phones, but I don't have. So. Huh. Well, now that's annoying. Okay. Never mind.
Warp drive active.
We will wait until we're ready to do this in a cruiser. Thank you.
warp drive active. Drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted. Warp drive active.
I also don't normally use a target painter, so that really could be making a huge difference for me. And also, I mean, to be honest, I think a lot of that was based on just experience from playing years ago when I didn't really understand. I didn't really understand how these ships worked in the same way that I do now. So. Probably get a blueprint for titanium Sabo. That's a good long range. Does pretty good damage. Using ranged, long-range weapons, like especially artillery, you know, where tracking can be an issue, this is always a good tactic, because another benefit, aside from keeping you hopefully out of range of their guns. Another benefit is they'll chase you, right? So that causes them to kind of line up behind you, which means they're not going around you. And so tracking is all about their transverse speed, right? So angular velocity, right? The speed at which your guns have to change their facing in order to track them. If they are not, then your guns don't need to track as quickly. Let's try. Coming in yet, so I'm kind of hoping this is the last ship. This has been longer than I planned on. That's the sound that says we completed mission. But of course we have salvage. Which will be a while, but yeah, I think like this mission is a good test of a ship, though. this mission, the blockade, which I've seen it come up in comments as a good way to test ship fits, at least for like destroyer and higher. I don't think I would want to try and do this in a frigate. I don't know, maybe a drone frigate with, you know, if you've got decent targeting and control range, like a Tristan or whatever the more advanced, I don't really know Galente ships that well, other than that the Tristan is the, like, drone frigate. Maybe a Kestrel if you've got decent missile skills. So that's the Caldari missile frigate. So you can get some pretty good range on that. So it would take a long time to do this mission, I think. In either of those ships, but they would allow you to keep out of range. So you wouldn't have to worry about tanking. Like, there's too many ships coming at once to rely on speed tank like you would in, like, a Rifter, for example. So, you know, I haven't, I've got some assault frigates on another character that I haven't actually done anything with yet, so I don't know. Maybe one of those would do the trick. But anyway, the rest of this video is going to be salvage, so if that's boring to you, then probably don't want to watch it. Sales. Could be either one. Honestly, I bet there was a fair amount of bounties from this. Mission, since that was a lot of pirate ships.
Thank you.
snake. Drone link augmenter increases the range of the drones. It's got energy neutralizers. Small ones, which is an interesting choice for a cruiser, but I guess I don't know much about neutralizers, so maybe there aren't medium ones. No idea. I guess I can understand having the armor maintenance bots also. I guess I'd just be concerned about, like, just getting stuck in the cycle of just healing and not doing damage, since the drones are, it's only damage dealing. So, of course, maybe the armor maintenance is not, drones are not meant to be used during combat. It would also be a totally reasonable choice. Or, you know, maybe just have one out to repair your drones or something. I mean, there's a couple of ways you could use that, I guess. Tanking a battleship, a battle cruiser, and a cruiser all at the same time. That's not bad, although I guess I'd want to see the fits on those ships also. But Let's see. On blaster, this is a comet. Navy comet. Okay, that's not a ship I'm familiar with. Federation Navy. Okay, frigate. Against three destroyers and a frigate. Too much different from my fire tail fit, I would say. Pretty much a brawler that kind of depends on speed to protect themselves from getting killed. Although he does have, okay, small ancillary armor repair, nanite paste, so he's got some tank. Okay. So yeah, I don't remember what rapid deployment does exactly. I mean, obviously it'll maybe align time, so agility or something. Alright, heavy pulse lasers, so designed for brawling, but I mean, if we're talking heavy guns, brawling range could be like 30 kilometers. I don't know lasers that well, so I don't know what the pulse lasers are, the sort of equivalent to autocannons, if I'm remembering correctly. Whereas beam lasers are basically the artillery, so this is going to be a relatively short-range ship, but on my autocannon battleship that I lost a while back, you know, with with phased plasma or hail, both of which reduce your range, I was looking at about 30 kilometers for fall off. Thruster. Warp Disruptor. Right. Repair Paste. Heatsink. Heatsink. Yeah, heatsinks do something to benefit lasers. I don't remember what. Multispectrum Coating, which I think is a passive. Resistance, medium ancillary armor repair, damage control, locus coordinator, so I think that's tracking speed, and drones. All right, so we're finally done with our salvage.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Just not bad.